In this illustration, we are going to study about de-excitation of a moving hydrogen atom. Here we are given to consider a hydrogen atom with its electron excited to another state moving at a speed v, where the speed is very less compared to the speed of light. It emits a photon in the direction of its motion and changes its state to a lower state m. Now it is saying if atom is kept at rest, then for the transition from n to m state, a frequency nu naught is emitted. And we are required to find the frequency of emitted photon when the atom is moving. Now here we can write in situation there are two cases. So when atom is at rest, then this is the situation when this is the hydrogen atom, which is kept at rest, and from the state of rest it emits a photon, then whole energy of de-excitation will be carried away by the photon, and if its frequency is nu naught, here we can write h nu naught is equals to, this is rch multiplied by 1 by, here it is transiting from n to m state, so it is 1 by m square minus 1 by n square. And in this situation, when the atom is moving, then the situation would be like this. The hydrogen atom is considered to be in motion with the speed v, and when it emits a photon in the direction of motion, here we can say in this situation its speed changes from v to v1, and the frequency emitted we can write as nu. So we can write when atom is moving, here we use this, the amount of energy which is overall released in de-excitation. So we can write initial energy of atom was half mv square plus the released energy is rch multiplied by 1 by m square minus 1 by n square. This should be the total energy after emission of this photon, where the remaining energy in the hydrogen atom is half mv1 square, and that is which is carried away by the photon as h nu. Here we can write v1 is the speed of hydrogen atom after photon emission. Now in this situation, say if this first equation, here we can also write by conservation of momentum, here we can use the initial momentum of hydrogen atom was mv, and after emission of this photon the momentum will change to mv1 plus, this will be h by lambda, which can be written as h nu by c, that is our second equation. Now in this state, from this equation 2, we can get the value of v1, which is equals to v minus h nu over mc. Now here from equation 1, if we substitute the value of v1, see what we'll be getting here. It is half mv square plus rch 1 by m square minus 1 by n square. This we can substitute as h nu naught, and this is equals to half m. Value of v1 we can substitute as v minus h nu by mc whole square plus h nu. Further, if you open this expression, you can see half mv square gets cancelled out. Let's open it now. This half mv square plus h nu naught is equals to, this gives us half mv square plus half m, this h nu by mc whole square minus, this will be mv h nu by mc, plus h nu. Now, in this situation, this half mv square gets cancelled out. In this term here, m also gets cancelled out. And here, we can ignore this term as in denominator c square is very high. So, we can ignore this term. So, finally, see what we are getting from these terms. We are getting nu multiplied by 1 minus v by c is equals to nu naught. Which further, if we simplify, this gives us nu is equals to nu naught 1 minus v by c to power minus 1. Which after binomial approximation, we can write it as nu naught multiplied by 1 plus v by c. That will be the result of this problem.